Our God is exalted. Praise God for the good news of the birth of Jesus as we celebrate together today. Our service today is Christmas Music Sunday with a mixture of scriptures, songs, and readings that tell the beautiful story of the gift of Christ for all humanity. The Advent responsive readings can be found in your bulletin. I will start with the first responsive reading. I will read the regular font. Please respond with the bold font. For the time is coming, says the Lord, when I will place a righteous branch upon King David's throne.
He shall be a king, he shall rule with wisdom and justice, and cause righteousness to prevail everywhere throughout the earth. And this is his name, the Lord our righteousness.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder.
These will be his royal titles: Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
His ever-expanding, peaceful government will never end. He will rule with perfect fairness and justice from the throne of his father, David. The royal line of David will be cut off, chopped down like a tree, but from the stump will grow a shoot. Yes, a new branch from the old root.
And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of his wisdom, understanding, counsel, and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord.
His delight will be obedience to the Lord. He will not judge by appearance, false evidence or hearsay, but will defend the poor and the exploited.
He will rule against the wicked who oppress them, for he will be clothed with fairness and truth. And Christ became a human being
and lived here on earth among us, full of loving kindness and truth. And we have seen his glory, the glory of the Son of God. We long for God's redemption and presence with us. In fact, the scripture says all of creation aches for this redemption. Please stand or feel free to remain seated as we sing, O Come, Emmanuel, found in the Gray Hymnal, number 123.
Thank you.
be seated.
Why, Lord, why? Why did you exchange the spaciousness of heaven and the warmth of your Father's presence for the squalor of a manger on earth and the limitations of life as a man? Why did you, who made the heavens, the mountains, the stars, the sun, strip yourself of your glory to become a helpless, homeless baby? Why did you come here to this spot, to Bethlehem? I came, my child, because I love you. I've always loved you, I will always love you. I came to rescue you from the clutches of the evil one, to deliver you from sin, to become your savior, to bring you into the spaciousness I enjoy. And I came, as the prophets foretold, to Bethlehem, to a woman's womb, to indwell you as I indwelt her, to become Emmanuel, God with you and in you. God came to us in the form of a baby, Jesus. It is by the love of God that Jesus came, and it is that same love that dwells within us today. Please stand or feel free to be seated today as we sing "Of the Father's Love Begotten," and is found in your gray hymnal, 118 in your gray hymnal. Please stand or feel free to be seated as we sing together. Please be seated. The second Advent responsive reading is about Mary. I will be reading the regular font. Please respond with the bold. God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a village in Galilee, to a virgin Mary, engaged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of King David. Don't be frightened, Mary, the angel told her, for God has decided to wonderfully bless you. Very soon now, you will become pregnant and have a baby boy, and you are to name him Jesus. Mary asked the angel, "But how can I have a baby? I'm a virgin."
The angel replied, "The Holy Spirit shall come upon you, and the power of God shall overshadow you. So the baby born to you will be utterly holy, the Son of God."
Mary said, "I am the Lord's servant, and I'm willing to do whatever he wants. May everything you said come true. Oh, how I praise the Lord, how I rejoice in God my Savior."
wrapped in swaddling clothes, he lies there, tiny fingers, tiny toes, his size no indication of his majesty and love. He came from heaven above, softly like a dove, God's Christmas child. Promised Prince of Peace, whose reign will never cease, Counselor and Mighty God is he. Father Everlasting, whose name is wonderful, packaged in a tiny child. Lord of ages past and future, Jesus first and last, here lies the God of all creation, of every land and nation, bringing us salvation with angels' glad ovation, God's Christmas child. Promised Prince of Peace, whose reign will never cease, Counselor and Mighty God is he. Father Everlasting, whose name is wonderful, packaged in a tiny child. Darkness ends at last, the light is here, how sad our past, and oh, we've waited far too long to hear the angel's song. Ring every bell and gong, he's come to right our wrong, God's Christmas child. Promised Prince of Peace, whose reign will never cease, Counselor and Mighty God is he. Father Everlasting, whose name is wonderful, packaged in a tiny child.
The glorious good news, the announcement of the birth of Christ, came from the angels, from the heavenly chorus, proclaiming peace on earth for all people. This morning, let us stand and do the same. If you're able, please stand as we sing, "It Came Upon a Midnight Clear," number 128 in the Gray Hymnal. "It Came Upon a Midnight Clear."
Thank you.
Well, good morning and Merry Christmas. What a joy it is to gather together in the house of the Lord this morning to lift our voices, to tune our minds, so to speak, to this season. When with anticipation and thanksgiving, we look to the coming of Christ to celebrate together, to worship together, to give praise together as one body. A special welcome to you if you're a guest, if you're in town visiting family, friends, or if you're just visiting First Baptist this morning, we want to extend a special welcome to you. If you are visiting as well, we want to invite you to look in the pews in front of you. You'll find a Connect card. Looks just like this. If you wouldn't mind grabbing that and filling that out sometime in the next minute or by the end of the service, you can drop it in the offering plates as they come around in just a moment, or one of the drop boxes in the lobby on your way out today. And that's just a way for one of us pastors here to follow up with you, to welcome you to the church, and maybe get you some more information or help you get connected to the community here. At this time, as we continue our worship in this Christmas season, we will be taking our morning offering. Giving back a portion of the many gifts that God has given us, especially in celebration of this season, with the greatest gift of the birth of Jesus in our world. So let's pray together as we prepare to give our tithes and offerings. Heavenly Father, it's with great thanksgiving that we gather in this place to sing of the joy, of the beauty, and of the mystery of that Christmas morning, the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ, into this world. Lord God, we thank you for everything that, that moment, that morning represents. The entry, the rescue, the way that you have not left your creation abandoned and hurting and broken, but God, that you loved us so much that you entered into our lowly state to share in the experience of your creation. Lord Jesus, that you would come in oppression, in humility, in vulnerability, in the form of a child, to dwell amongst us, to share the life that we live. And God, we give you thanks this day that we can celebrate, that we can honor that gift that you have given of yourself unto us. Lord, we ask that we would be able to give back not just money, not just time, not just our energy, but our whole lives in thanksgiving for the way that you have gifted us with new life through the coming of your Son, Jesus. Be with us today, we ask, in your holy name, Jesus. Amen.
Thank you. The third Advent response to reading is about Joseph and the shepherds. It's in the bulletin. I will read the regular font. Please respond with the bold. About this time, Caesar Augustus, the Roman emperor, decreed that a census should be taken throughout the nation. And because Joseph was a member of the royal line, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, King David's ancient home, journeying there from Galilean village of Nazareth. And she gave birth to her first child, a son. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the village inn.
That night, some shepherds were in the fields outside the village, driving their flocks to sheep. Suddenly, an angel appeared
among them, and the landscape shone bright with the glory of the Lord. They were badly frightened, but the angel reassured them. "Do not be afraid," he said. "I bring you the most joyous news ever announced, and it is for everyone.
The Savior, yes, the Messiah of the Lord, has been born tonight in Bethlehem. How will you recognize him? You will find the baby wrapped in a blanket, lying in a manger."
Suddenly, the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God. "Glory to God in the highest heaven," they sang, "and peace on earth for all those pleasing Him." They ran to the village and found their way to Mary and Joseph. And there was the baby lying in a manger. The shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child.
To this baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully. The Son of God, the angel said, how could it be?
The announcement of Christ's birth came to the shepherds. These were the workers who were often outcast in society. The greatest news of all came to the lowest, God's way of bringing hope to all people. Please stand or feel free to remain seated as we sing, "While Shepherds Watch Their Flock," found in Gray Hymnal number 135. Please be seated.
Please join me for the fourth responsive reading. The fourth Advent responsive reading is about the wise men. I will read the regular font. Please respond with the bold. Jesus was born in the town of Bethlehem in Judea during the reign of King Herod.
At about that time, some astrologers from eastern lands arrived in Jerusalem
King Herod was deeply disturbed by their questions, and all Jerusalem was filled with rumors. He called a meeting of the Jewish religious leaders. "Did the prophets tell us where the Messiah would be born?" he asked.
"Yes, in Bethlehem," they said, "for this is what the prophet Micah wrote. O little town of Bethlehem, you are not among your born Judean village, for a governor shall rise from you to rule my people Israel."
Then Herod sent a private message to the astrologers, asking them to come see him. At this meeting, he found out from them the exact time when they first saw the star.
"Then he told them, 'Go to Bethlehem, search for the child, and when you find him, come back and tell me, so that I can go and worship him too.'"
After this interview, the astrologers started out again. And look, the star appeared to them again, standing over Bethlehem. Their joy knew no bounds. But when they returned to their own land, they didn't go through Jerusalem to report to Herod, for God had warned them in a dream to go home another way. This is the story of how the great hymn, "O Little Town of Bethlehem," came to be. When Philip Brooks was rector of the Holy Trinity Episcopal Church in Philadelphia, he was asked to write a special song for the Sunday school Christmas celebration. "What shall I write?" he wondered. "How can I challenge the hearts and minds of our Sunday school with regard to Christ's birth, the place and manner of his birth, the reason for his birth, and the necessity of our new birth?" After much prayer, he felt that the Lord was bringing into focus an experience he had had 2 to 3 years earlier in the Holy Land. On Christmas Eve, he had stood for a long time on a hillside and looked out over sleeping Bethlehem. In his imagination, Brooks could see a weary couple making their way to the stable of an inn. There was no room for them in the guest section. Too many great ones had made advance reservations. A few moments later, he seemed to hear angel voices announcing to surprised shepherds, "Behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." He imagined that he could hear the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." How sad, he thought, that in the inn there was no room for the one of whom the angel sang. No room for the Son of God who, though he was rich, yet for man's sake became poor, and through his poverty we might be made rich. But conditions have not changed. Men still reject this one who willingly took upon himself the form of man in order to pay the penalty of sin for man. From this reverie, Brooks turned to go to a midnight service where he was pledged and he prayed. "O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us today." Brooks put his thoughts into verse, and when he had finished, he went to Louis H. Redner, the organist and Sunday school superintendent, and said, "If you will write a suitable tune for these words, I will name it for you." On Christmas Eve, the tune still had not come to Redner, Somewhat discouraged, he went to bed. And as he slept, he dreamed he heard angels singing. He awoke, took up pen and paper, and set down the melody he felt was a direct gift from God. Imagine the feeling of no place to go. Even when we reject Christ, he still finds a way to enter our hearts and our lives and our world. Praise be to God. Please stand, and if you need to, feel free to sit and join us in singing, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
In all the history of the world, there was only one who ever was chosen to be born. He chose to be cradled in the arms of an unknown peasant lass. He chose the tender care of a humble carpenter. He chose to be born as a traveler. He chose the strange comforts of a manger and the animal warmth and smell of a stable for his first earthly experiences. He chose to be weaned as an exile. He chose to be reared by quiet Joseph and mild Mary. He chose the fare of a poor peasant's home, a carpenter's home, to eat the dark crust of poverty in the inconspicuous and erstwhile unknown town of Nazareth, nestled high in the Galilean hills. And then one day he chose a cross and died for all our sins. Just as that first Christmas, so still today, he chooses to dwell in poor men's homes, to hear praise from shepherds' lips, to receive gifts from wise men's hands, as the old hymn says. And in this world of sin, where mixed souls will receive him still, there Christ enters in. God spoke through his creation, but people did not see. God spoke through his law, but they did not understand. God spoke through his prophets, but they did not listen. So God spoke through his Son, and when the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, people saw, understood, and listened to his love for them. Today, God speaks through his children. When his children allow the Word to become flesh through their sacrificial acts of love, others see and experience Christ in their lives. Merry Christmas.
This Christmas season, we invite every one of us to make room in our hearts, in our lives, in our relationships, for Jesus to be present. Let us give our hearts once again to Jesus. Please stand or feel free to be seated as we sing "In the Bleak Midwinter." It's found in the red hymnal in front of you, hymn number 128, the red hymnal. 128. Please stand and sing together, or feel free to be seated.
Thank you.
Please be seated.
Good morning, everyone. At this time, I'm Mary Gray. As on behalf of Deacon's team, I would like to acknowledge our wonderful pastors and administration staff to come up to acknowledge our gratitude, and we'd like to pray. So Pastor Greg and Caroline, Children's Ministry, and please come, family too, and come on up. And Pastor Grant, I believe, is away, and Pastor Josh and his lovely wife, Allison, and Lily, and Erin, our administration staff, she's also away, and also Pastor Lily for Chinese ministry, and did I miss anybody? I think that's it. So, okay, I think I'm going to be... So. The deacon team, I'm doing for on behalf of deacon team to give thanks to all our wonderful pastors. So I just want to let everybody know what they do a little bit behind the scene. Erin Ferry, she is our staff and work for the administration at the office. And her husband, Chris, and she has two children. So, and a Pastor Lily, so I just gonna give special thanks to this envelope, and please hold the applause until the end. So Pastor Lily, so she is our pastor for, especially for Chinese ministry, so a lot of Chinese group meet together, and not only just a Chinese group, but basically she does wonderful job, and also she had to go through a little challenging physically this year, but God continued to heal her, and she's now back. We're just so thankful. So this is for Pastor Lily. Sorry, this is my very first time doing this, so please forgive me. So this is for Pastor Lily. Thank you so much. Oh. And so next is Pastor Josh. Pastor Josh, he is our student ministry pastor. Yes, please. Thank you. We didn't discuss, so please forgive me. yes. And Pastor Josh. Yes, Pastor Josh and his lovely wife, Allison, she also is she's a mission person as well for the New England area for boarding school. Yes, and they have a lovely, lovely Lily. So she came to their life this year and become official just recently. Thank you so much. And so Pastor Brandt, he's away for family vacation, but he and his wife, Erin, and he has three beautiful children. So he's an executive pastor, and he does wonderful worship and organize everything, and finance, and behind the scene. He has so many work you probably do not know. I don't know either, but he does a lot of things. So let's thank him too, wherever he is. And and next is our children's ministry pastor, Caroline. And Carolyn. And Carolyn is also a wonderful wife of our Pastor Greg. And Pastor Greg this morning reminded me this is their 20th Christmas here. Is that right? Yeah. Okay. So wonderful. Thank you so much. And Caroline does all these summer vacation BBS, which has lots of work going on. I kind of see the glimpse of, I help a little bit of like painting job, but oh, she does everything. There's so much work going on too. So please continue to pray for this wonderful ministry. Thank you so much, Caroline. And yes. The last but not least, it's our wonderful senior pastor, Pastor Greg. So, is Anne here too? Oh, and so they have wonderful two children, and one, Anne, older one, is here with us from Philadelphia. Thank you so much. And so we have wonderful team of this staff, and I don't know how much I can be thankful. And so I would like to pray with benediction, this Christmas benediction. And I really have to say thank you to Sue, who was a deacon head a few years. And so I have to call her to help me, Sue. So I'm just going to read this, but with prayerful heart. So please bow, please. We have sung a song without ending, a song telling the story which includes each of us, a story of which we are a part. So let us go out to live with story to tell of the hope that is being born among us this Christmas, to share the love of the season with the world, to be agents of peace in times of trouble, to sing songs of deep and abiding joy. May the grace of God, the love of our Savior, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit abide with you this Christmas and evermore. Amen.
Before we go out, just I want to say thank you so much for coming to worship with us today. Just a reminder that tomorrow night we have a Christmas Eve worship celebration at 7 p.m. right here. So we hope you'll join us for that. And also we're having a Christmas gift wrapping party right now in the back for our shelter gifts. So if you want to stick around, grab a cup of coffee or hot chocolate, wrap some presents, we'd love for you to stay with us for that time. So thank you so much for being here.